What's up with the YouTube fam, man? Look, this video was already complete, you know what I'm saying? But I had to go do some brief research, that way when y'all watch this video, y'all can have some clarity on certain things that took place during this video. But I do want to start off by saying that I did chuckle a little bit during this video, and I want to stress the fact that don't take that as me being insensitive. These are real raw reaction videos, so when I see certain things and they catch me off guard, I might chuckle, I might do some shit that y'all might not be cool with, because y'all already coming into these videos knowing what's going on sometimes, and I don't be knowing. So yeah, his family being out there taking up for him and saying what they said just caught me off guard, you feel me? So I don't want y'all to feel like I'm being insensitive. But overall, man, you know, I was saying that I feel like the mom should have been a little bit calmer in front of her children and things like that, which I still stand on top of that, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, I can understand it more. As I thought about it a little bit more over and over and over, when you try to harm me or my child, whether it's intentional or not, it's up even after you die. So I can understand her, you know what I'm saying, her frustrations and the way that she was out there moving, you feel me? Now, I'm not saying it's all the way right, but you know, when it comes to your children, it's no understanding. So I'm not going to sit here and just follow her, none of that. But yeah, man, like I said before, man, I feel like that she should have chilled, because when somebody passes away, they done. It's a wrap. You really won. That's how I look at this shit. If I got a problem with somebody and they pass away, hell, I done won. That's how I feel, you know what I'm saying? And I'm just keeping it 100 with y'all. I'm not finna sugarcoat how I'm feeling. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people be acting like they holier than thou and they don't have thoughts like that and shit like that. Man, I'm gonna keep it real and raw with y'all. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. But yeah, the guy was having a mental breakdown. So he wasn't even in his right mind when he did what he did. But you know, that ain't no excuse to do none of this shit. And she was right when she said that y'all should have been helping him from the beginning. You know what I'm saying? I rock with that all the way, because they should have been there helping him more if they knew that he was going to trip out like this. But at the same time, man, we don't know what the hell led up to none of this. So I can't sit here and just look down on a man, you know what I'm saying? Because everybody go through shit. We just don't know what they're going through. But, you know, when it comes to these kids, man, it ain't no excuse for it. So it is what it is. But I'm going to go ahead and let y'all get into the video. I'm going to holler at y'all a little bit later. I just have to say what I have to say real quick. Give y'all some updates. You know what I'm saying? I rock with her. She did what she had to do, and I ain't gonna look down on her. I respect it, you know what I'm saying? And it is what it is, you know? I'll holler at y'all later. What's up with the YouTube fam, man? I'm back again with another video. Look, man, long story short, it's a lady who is going viral right now, you know what I'm saying? And basically what's going on with this story right here, man, it was a guy, his life was taken by police officers, and they were having a protest and everything about, you know what I'm saying, him being gunned down by police officers, right? Well, a lady that he shot at came to the protest and just shut it down, you know what I'm saying? Like, was out there cutting up. You know, I've been seeing different clips and shit like that, but I finally found the video, a full video of everything that took place with this whole situation right here. You know, but she was just basically letting everybody know that he wasn't the type of person that they should be idolizing or praising or whatever they call themselves doing, you know what I'm saying? Protesting for him and things like that. Now, you know, I look at everything on both sides. I'm just not going to take her side, and I'm not going to take his side. I feel like that people got the right to do what they want to do with their loved ones. If people out there genuinely have a love for him, they got every right to be doing a protest and shit like that. And she got every right to be as mad as she is, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like that when somebody dies, that's it. So why go out there and do all this extra shit, you know what I'm saying? But you can't tell nobody how to react, because this can be very traumatizing to her, especially knowing that he shot at her and her children, you know what I'm saying? Allegedly, that's what they say. I don't know how true this is, but it is what it is, you know? Like I always say, man, I don't be knowing exactly what's going on with certain situations, so I'm just giving you my opinion on it. I don't want to be having to deal with all this extra shit from these people, you know what I'm saying? But anyways, man, long story short, she went out there acting a fool on them and shit like this. So if you're going to check it out, I'm going to tell you what I feel about it during the video and after the video. So if you don't hear me talking at any point in time during this video, that's on my channel. Just get up off my channel, go find it somewhere else if you can find it. If you can't find it, that's on you. I really don't give a damn about you. No way, so it is what it is. But to all my loyal supporters and my new supporters, man, y'all already know I'm not talking to y'all when I say that. All I want y'all to do is hit the like button for me and tell me what y'all feel about everything in the comment section. And make sure I add up my social medias as well, my Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram. All that's going to be in the comment section if y'all want to add that. If y'all don't want to add none of that, I'm not doing no tripping. And then my second YouTube channel too is called Carlos King 2. That's if y'all want to add that also. If y'all don't want to add none of that, I'm not doing no tripping on none of that. Let's get into it and see what the hell going on with this though.
Give me my idols, because you guys are celebrating his life.
It was
terrible.
I'm sure it was
terrible. Okay. Yeah, okay.
You're lying.
You're lying.
You're
okay.
Shut up.
You're
damn, they talking about shut up.
Grief and silence.
He said, fuck all that, man. You good. You know what I'm saying? Like I said before, they got every right to be out there grieving. You know what I'm saying? Like I said before, she got every right to do this, but reacting. He's dead. His life is gone already. You know what I'm saying? I be feeling like shit. When somebody die, if you got a real problem with them, man, you done won. That's just how I feel about it. I'm going to keep 1,000 with y'all. I ain't going to be sitting over here doing all the extra shit at the extra craze that they done passed, and people want to show him love, let them show him love. You know what I'm saying? Shit, he tried to kill me. He lost his life, so it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? I already won in my eyes, you feel me? Now, I know I might be wrong to some of y'all, but I'm just stating facts on how I feel. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's no use to doing it. It's like overkill. You know what I'm saying? You know, but let's get back into it, man. And like I said before, this is my opinion. I'm not trying to argue with nobody about how I feel. You know what I'm saying? But let's get back into it.
They have a mental illness now because they almost lost their life.
They're... Hold on. What the hell she said? Who got a mental illness now?
He was unarmed.
You're alive.
This is not okay. My kids have to deal with this and probably have a mental illness now because they almost lost their life. There's bullet holes in my kitchen.
How did you know?
In the fucking hallway, watching my move. I wish it never happened either. Now I don't have a place to call home. I can't sleep at night.
She's obviously going through a moment.
This is not okay.
This is what they want to show on the TV. She's obviously going through a moment.
This is not okay. Just go home.
She
go
true.
Home. There's none of you guys knocked on that man's door to check his health.
Shut up.
No, he did not come. He did not decide to not come and visit me.
This is not the time. This is not the time to play.
It wasn't. This is my dumb man. It's all mad. It's all mad. It's all mad. Man, like, no, because you think I'm trying to get on my kids in the car.
Her kids in the car hollering and yelling and her constantly reminding them about this. You know what I'm saying? Now, this can be a traumatizing situation. You know, I'm not going to take nothing away from that part of it. But, you know, sometimes kids can overlook things. It's how much you amplify a situation. How much you present it to them is how much they're going to remember that shit. You know what I'm saying? So I just honestly feel like that, you know, she should be trying to let them get past this. She should be grieving in peace right now. You know what I'm saying? I mean, didn't nobody die, but y'all get what I'm saying. She should be doing whatever she got going on in peace, trying to see if they okay. But she adding on to the mental trauma and stress that they could possibly be going through. You know what I'm saying? Your children are a sponge. They react off what they see from you, and they get more. You know what I'm saying? Amplified in certain situations that you get amplified in. You get what I'm saying? If you turned up about something, they're going to get turned up about it. But you know, the least amount of attention that you add to a situation, you know what I'm saying? They're going to be prone to look past that. You know what I'm saying? So she amplifying this. I mean, now, if somebody was to do that to your family and things like that, I can understand y'all being mad as hell. And at the same time, you got to understand that this person has already died. It's nothing that you can do. This right here just adding insult to injury. You know what I'm saying? My bad, man. My camera over here tripping and stuff like that. It might look a little different now because the light going in and out. But, yeah, man, I feel like that I can understand her frustration all the way around because their life could have been taken just like that due to somebody else's negligence and them acting crazy as hell. But I do feel like that she's putting too much on it in front of the children and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like that she shouldn't be acting like this at all in front of them, you know. But I do understand her frustrations all the way around. You know what I'm saying? If you're going to act like this, do this shit away from the children. You know what I'm saying? Don't make it be so much on their mind the way that she's putting it on there, you know. That's just how I feel about it. I ain't going to lie to y'all about nothing. You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. Let's get back into it, though.
He tried to kill me in front of my kids. There's bullet, there was casings in the hallway. The shot went through my door to the pillar to the kitchen. I was cooking food for my kids. It shouldn't, no, it doesn't matter. He shouldn't have been dead. Y'all should have came and helped him when he was alive.
Yeah, a lot of anger and frustration from the mother who lived next door to Tekle Sundberg. An emotional evening as Arabella Yarborough recounts the night of the hours-long standoff at her Minneapolis apartment complex. That six-hour standoff Thursday morning ending with police shooting Tekle Sundberg multiple times, killing him. Today, community members gathered for a protest against police violence. Mary McGuire joins us now, and Mary, tensions running very high as family remembers the man who was killed.
And Karen, as you heard there, some powerful and very contentious moments at that rally for Tekle Sundberg, who was shot and killed by Minneapolis police early Thursday morning. Now this afternoon, just as the protest was starting to get underway against police violence, the woman who lived in the apartment directly next door to Tekle showed up. Her name is Arabella Yarborough, and she says she was cooking dinner for her two young children on Wednesday night when bullets began flying through her walls. She shared these photos of the aftermath of the shooting with us that show multiple bullet holes through her front door and through her bathroom wall. She confronted the family of Tekle, saying she had 5 minutes to live while Tekle had 6 hours to choose life or death.
That man was armed. George Floyd was not armed. Breonna Taylor was not armed. Amir Lockheed, he was armed, and he had his own guns, but they came into his home while he's licensed to carry and killed him. He did not shoot fire. This man attempts to try to kill us.
We can feel terribly for this woman, but also remember that Tekle should be here with us, and he should be alive, and we can ask the Minneapolis Police Department to do better.
Now that was Jeff Storms, the attorney for the Sundberg family. Sundberg's parents were also at this protest. They adopted Tekle from Ethiopia when he was just 4 years old. They also expressed their remorse for everything that Yarborough experienced on the night of the standoff. They say the shooting through her apartment walls and the killing of their son are two separate incidents that should have been handled in very different ways. Now, attorney Jeff Storms says that he has requested that the family of Tekle view any body camera video that perhaps was caught the night of the shooting. The city attorney's office says that they are pouring through all of that footage now and that it will be shown to the family before it is released to the public. We still don't have a timeline on when that could all happen. Reporting live in Minneapolis tonight, Mary McGuire, Fox 9.
But yeah, man, you know, long story short, man, I do sympathize for her. You know, I'm not going to look down on her situation or anything like that. I just feel like some bullet holes do give me a different type of response. You know what I'm saying? It kind of makes me understand why she was so mad. But, I mean, it's just hard for me to put it how I really want to put it because I don't want nobody to think I'm being insensitive to both families. You know what I'm saying? If anything, I would be more happy than mad because we did survive this situation. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, it can be frustrating all the way around because, you know, how people being so crazy these days, man. They killing everybody around them, kids and things like that, too. If anything, I feel like she should be more happy than anything that she is alive. You know what I'm saying? Because it could have went a whole other way. You know, I mean, there's just more reason to praise God. You know what I'm saying? And just be more thankful to have life, you know. But after doing all this extra shit, man, I won't even give any people my energy, bro. You know what I'm saying? Somebody who I heard didn't care about life got his life taken. So, yeah, man, you should just chill. You know what I'm saying? Let the shit go how it's going to go. But, you know, like I said before, you can't tell nobody how to react to a certain situation. So, you know, it is what it is. Like I said, I do understand her doing this. I'm just saying what I wouldn't do, you know. But I want to know what y'all feel about everything in the comment section. Y'all like, comment, subscribe, if you like my commentary. If you don't like my commentary, I really don't give a damn. I'll holler at y'all if you let on another video, though. All right.